Imagine a 14-year-old child is being told by a deputy sheriff to do a particular action. The child does that particular action and the child dies because of the deputy and the deputy's words. Let's put his picture up full mask. That's exactly what happened to this 14-year-old child, Andrew Joseph III. Finally, the family of Andrew Joseph III will get their day in court. This happened years ago. This is a highlight of the criminal justice system moving in a very different way against members of law enforcement. This happened February 7th, 2014. This young man, this child, was hit by a vehicle when attempting to cross the interstate in Tampa, Florida. The reason he was hit was because of what the cops told him to do. I'm going to give you some background to this. His parents and family supporters have argued for years. Had it not been for the Hillsborough Sheriff's Office, that 14-year-old child would be alive today. Now, after 8 years, parents are finally getting their chance to hold the sheriff's office accountable and the deputies who were responsible for the death of this 14-year-old child. There's a wrongful death lawsuit that has received the go-ahead in federal court. What led to the death? In 2014, Joseph, along with many other children, were at the Florida State Fair when a fight broke out among some of the kids, causing Hillsborough Sheriff's deputies to intervene. Joseph was waiting in line to get on an amusement ride, and he was not part of the fight at all. However, he was still rounded up along with the other children and kicked out of the park by deputies, okay? So remember, he's black, he's young, he's not involved in the fight. He's in line trying to actually enjoy himself. He gets rounded up, he gets thrown out. He had absolutely nothing to do with the violence that has already been proven, documented, and settled. Okay, there's more. According to court documents obtained by the Tampa Bay Times, the children were in deputy's custody for a little less than 45 minutes. Then placed in sheriff's vans, then driven away from fair entrance gates and finally dropped off at the edge of the fairgrounds near a busy interstate. It was Interstate 4. The Times also reported on record a deposition from another teenager with Joseph at the time of the accident said a deputy guarding one of the fair entrances told the children, and I quote, "The only thing separating them from the main entrance gate to the fair is the interstate," prompting the children, including the 14-year-old Joseph, to cross the interstate where he was hit by an SUV. The driver was not charged. Let's put up the parents who have been seeking justice, an opportunity to hold those accountable, responsible for their son's death. Since 2014, Joseph's parents, Deanna and Andrew Joseph Jr., have tried to hold the Hillsborough Sheriff's deputies accountable. But despite their wrongful death lawsuit filed back in 2016 against the sheriff's office, the Florida State Fair Authority, and the Hillsborough County School Board, their case has been repeatedly delayed with appeals to the sheriff's office citing qualified immunity. There it is again. Qualified immunity has protected them, has protected these cops from day one. Qualified immunity should be no more. It is a ridiculous, horrible, anti-democracy, anti-transparency, and anti-fairness doctrine. It was rooted in southern states creating an opportunity, a barrier, so that white cops could brutalize black children without having a civil liability when they were sued. That's why this qualified immunity dynamic was created in the first place. There's more. Joseph family finally made a breakthrough last year on October 12th when a panel of federal judges rejected finally the sheriff's office appeal, preventing them from using qualified immunity in the case, clearing the path to a federal trial. Now, why did the federal court, why did these judges make a decision to set aside qualified immunity? While I cannot speak to the summary of their reason, I can speak to the statutory dynamics of the rule. If it is determined that an officer's action is so egregious and so negligent and so outside of the normative duty or scope of their operation, a judge can decide to set aside qualified immunity. And that is exactly what these judges have decided to do. Let's put up the pictures of the leadership, Hillsborough, okay? The current sheriff, his name is Chad Cronister. He was appointed in 2017 following former sheriff David Gies on the right's retirement, right? The federal wrongful death case blames the sheriff's office for the teen's death and for violating his civil rights. The trial is expected to last until the end of September. The day before the trial began, on September 12th, the Joseph family and the Florida State Fair Authority reached an undisclosed settlement. A jury is expected to decide if deputies will be held accountable in Andrew Joseph III's death at the trial's conclusion. I bring this story to your attention because I want you to remember the number 8. 8 years. 8 years. And as soon as a judge, a federal judge, makes the right decision, everything starts moving in the right direction. The company decides to do the right thing, create a settlement rather than a fight. The officers are not being held accountable. 8 years. What was the one thing preventing this family from receiving justice in 8 days or 8 months? It was qualified immunity. The qualified immunity clause, which has been not only problematic, but obviously is opposite of holding somebody accountable. There's no such thing as qualified immunity for medical doctors that kill patients. There's no such thing as qualified immunity for, let's say, a professor that has an inappropriate relationship with a student. There's a higher level of accountability for every single profession, except for policing. They are the only profession in America where there's a lower standard of accountability rather than a higher one. You get certified, you get commissioned to do something, no matter what it is, you have a higher standard of accountability for that post, except for policing. Sharon, thoughts here?
Boy, so many. You know, these delays over 8 years, Dr. Richey, were set up, and it's designed in America to force black parents, beautiful black parents, and I can't look at that picture anymore of him in that graduation outfit. It forces them to prove that they also love their children. That's exactly what it does. And this, I think you called it rounding up that occurred at the fair that day. That's exactly what it was, a catacall. He was kidnapped, right? I had nothing to do with it except being brown. And I was kidnapped and told, get to the other side. They used to do that, boy, century ago, some places in the South still today, where they we'll let you go, now run. Yeah. And we know what happens then. It's the same thing. It is disgusting. And there is no justice, but there's got to be a resolve here for this family.
Yeah, and we will bring the update as it comes. There should be an update very soon.